Now with this exercise, we're going to recap on creating blocks again, and now you will see the enhancement that's been added to the block creation that you can move the content to layer 0. Now in this drawing, as you can see, if I select my polyline, you will see that my polyline is on layer number 2. If I select my rectangle, that is on layer number 1. And if I select a portion of my chair, that's on layer number 3. So it's different components on different layers. So I'm going to select all of that. I'm going to right click and I'm going to make a copy of it first. I can make use of C on the keyboard because we're going to create 2 blocks. Now the first block that we're going to create is keep everything default. So I'm going to say make block and I'm going to call it table original. I'm going to say pick for the origin and I'm going to indicate the origin of my block. Now at the bottom right hand side, that's new enhancement to Carry 26, is that I can ask Carry, although it's on different layers, please move the objects to layer 0. But the first one, I'm just going to keep it switched off so you can see the difference between the two, the advantage. So if I'm going to say OK, I've created the block. As you can see, if I select it, it says block reference 1. So let's select the second one. The second one, I'm going to make use of the new enhancement. So I'm going to say make block. I'm going to say table. But this time I'm going to say layer 0. Because I'm going to ask Carry to move the objects to layer 0. I'm going to say pick for origin and indicate the origin. I'm going to say OK. So now I've got these two blocks. So I'm just going to save this file. And now I'm going to go to a new drawing and I'm going to bring in those blocks. Now you can make use of your component manager. So I'm just going to go to view, component manager. And in my component manager, I've got a shortcut for it to go to that particular file. We've just created those blocks. And as you can see, those that's not familiar with the component manager, it displays all the content of a specific file. So I want to see the blocks in that file. And as you can see, these are the two blocks we've just created. So I'm first going to bring in the one, the original one. Now have a look and see. My active layer at the moment is on layer number 5. So I'm going to double click. It's attached to my pointer and I can place my block symbol. So I'm going to just close this component manager and then I'll show you what happened here. If I select the block, in my object properties, my control point of my block will be on layer number 5 because that's my active layer. But if I go to layer display, and I go to layer 1, it will show me the content of that block that was created on those layers. So the control point of the block is on layer number 5, but the content is on layer 1, 2, 3 and 4. So now we're going to bring in the other block that we've created with the new feature that everything moves to layer 0. So I'm going to activate my component manager again. And I'm going to double left click on my new block. And I'm going to place it next to it. Now once again, my active layer is on layer 5. So I'm going to place my block. I'm going to press escape. Close my component manager. So have a look and see what happened now. If I select my block, once again, my origin of my block is on layer number 5, but if I now go to my layer display, have a look. If I go to layer 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So what happened now is, although the components is on layer 1, 2, 3 and 4 created, I've asked Carry to move everything to layer number 0. But because I bring it in on layer number 5, it will display the visibility of all those objects on that one layer. So that is the advantage of creating blocks, using the option to move all the objects to layer 0. Also a nice enhancement is that if you've got two blocks, there's one block, there's another block. I can now in Carry 26, we can merge, we can add a block to an existing block. That means it's become nested. So I'm going to select the block I want to edit. I'm going to right click. I'm going to go down to my block. I'm going to say edit block. If I'm going to right click, I'm going to ask Carry, merge objects into block. So I'm going to click on the command. Carry will ask me, indicate object to add. So I'm going to click on my second block. Carry picks up that it's a block, so it will tell me, selected object is a block. Adding it will create a nested block. Do you want to continue? I'm going to say yes. I'm going to press escape. Right click, end edit block. If I now click on it, as you can see, there is now one single individual block. I've added a second block. Now that you understand the blocks, now we're going to add the attribute to it and you will see the announcement that's been added for creating attributes. So I'm going to select my block. As you can see, it's a block reference. I'm going to right click, go to my block and I'm going to ask how to edit my block. So now I'm in edit mode. As you can see, I can select my lines. So I'm going to add the attribute. So to add an attribute, we go to modify. We go down to blocks. And at the bottom says block attributes. So I'm going to click on it. And the first one we're going to start off, it says create attribute. So I'm going to click on create attribute. Now, if you're familiar up to Caddy 25, you will see that the dialog looks slightly different. As you can see, you've got your text settings now. My justification, I'm going to set it to middle center. My text style that I want to use. My text height. And then I'm going to specify on screen. And now new to Caddy 26 is the option that we can make use of multiple lines. But I'm going to show that after this presentation. So I'm just going to stick to the basics first. So if it's a single attribute you want to add, I'm going to keep it lock position in block. My value, I'm going to keep my value empty. Because what I want to do is, I want Caddy to prompt me the person name. And then I'm going to type it in. Because I'm going to place my desks. And then I want to add it to a table. And as well as add my attributes to a table separately from the normal block scheduling. So I'm going to say OK, and Caddy will ask me pick point to insert attribute definition. So I indicate where my tag need to be, right click option end, end edit block. Caddy will ask me update attribute. I'm going to say yes. And as you can see now, it prompts me the person name. So now I can type in Vic. I'm going to say OK, and it places the name. So now the attribute is within the block. As you can see, as I move my block, my attribute is in the block. So now what I want to do is, I want to bring in another three tables, and then we're going to schedule them, and then you will see the advantage. So next step will be to bring in the block. We go to modify block, insert block. I'm going to select my block. I'm going to say OK. And as soon as I'm going to place it, that's the advantage of using an attribute in your block. It pops up, and now I can type in the next person name. I'm going to say OK, and as you can see, it did place it. The next desk, I'm going to say Gerard. And the next one, Shal. So, at the moment, as you can see, I've got four blocks there, and now we're going to schedule them. Now, that's standard up to Caddy 25, so we just go to modify, we go to block, and we go down to schedule blocks. Caddy picks up that there's only one block in my drawing. I'm going to ask Caddy for my selection to search over my whole drawing. That is the column header, very straightforward. So it's only the one block that I'm going to schedule. That's my table detail. And I'm going to say OK. And Caddy will ask me, indicate the top left point for the table. So now I can place my table. And if I zoom out, you will see that Caddy picks up that there's four blocks. Now, as you can see, at the moment, it did a count of my blocks, but I would like to have a table where it tells me, okay, it's a table with the names, with the attributes in the table. So that's the new enhancement that's in Caddy 26. So what we're going to do is we're going to go back to modify, we go to blocks, and we go down to block attributes. Because now new to Caddy 26, you've got your attribute manager. So if I click on it, I've made use only of one block in this drawing. So if you had more than one, as you can see, you have the option to move up or move down. You have the option to edit. That means your text properties. If you want to like to change that particular attribute, the text style, you've got miscellaneous properties. So all the settings are still available for editing. So I'm going to say OK. So the one that we're going to use now is, if I go to my attributes, is the one that says extract attribute in table. So if I click on the command, Caddy will ask me, extract all attributes from block references in my model space, or do I want to be selective, only a portion of my drawing. So it's up to you. So I'm going to say OK, and I'm going to define, I would like to schedule those four attributes. Caddy picks up the block, it picks up the tag. Now I'm going to ask Caddy to give me a presentation of my block. So I'm going to say OK, Caddy will ask me to indicate first corner of table. So now I can create the table, R for regen, and as you can see, it gives me the name of my block, it gives me a presentation of my block reference, and then on the right hand side, there you can see that's my attribute that's added to the block. That's the advantage. So now what we're going to do is, you can rearrange stuff inside your attribute. So if I'm going to go back to my modify, blocks, block attribute, we've already covered the extract attribute. You can add block to an attribute. You can say rearrange attribute table. Caddy ask us indicate the table associated with attributes. going to indicate the table, and now I can say, right, Gerard, I would like to move him up, and I would like to move Leonie up as well. Dus Gerard, Leonie, Vic and Charles. So I'm going to say, okay, R4Gen, as you noticed, it did update. So when it comes to your attributes, now we can export it to a table. Now, another nice enhancement is that I just show you that you can create a single attribute into a block. Now you can actually add multiple lines in one attribute. So I'm going to select my block again, right click, we go to block, edit block, and I'm going to go to edit attribute. So I go to my blocks, block attribute, create attribute, exactly the same path as what we did. The difference now is, now I'm going to ask Caddy, instead of make use of single line attributes, I would like to make use of multiple lines. So this time I'm going to, at the value, you can see it's blanked out. I'm going to click on the option and it opens my text editor. So this time I can say, for instance, name. Below that I can say division. And below that I can say office number. So as soon as I'm going to say OK, once again, my justification, I can decide I would like to have middle center, my text style, my text height, and I'm going to say OK. Caddy will ask me, pick point to insert attribute definition, indicate the position, and as soon as I'm going to go end edit block, Caddy will ask me, update attribute, I'm going to say yes, and I can edit the value. So now this time, I'm going to say once again, let's say it's Vic, division is sales, office number 2. So as soon as I'm going to say OK, click on OK, R4Gen, as you can see, it did update my block with multiple line attributes. So if I'm going to bring in that same block again now, insert block, I'm going to select my desk, I'm going to say OK, as soon as I'm going to place it, can just click on the value, it opens, and now I can say Gerard, division, sales as well, office number 3. I say OK, as you can see it at the attributes. So that's a new enhancement when it comes to your attributes. You can have multiple lines in your attributes inside your block.